are back on Kababayan today. It's time to get personal with our beautiful friend, Alice Dixon. Alice,
yes.
Where did you get married?
In Canada.
Good choice, because you know what? If you did it in the Philippines, no divorce.
Where did you get married?
I got married in the Philippines.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well,
but,
you don't.
Well, here's the thing, and this is what I want to talk to you about, because mm-hmm. you are divorced. You're very open about your being divorced,
yeah.
but a lot of our Kababayans in the Philippines don't have that option.
Yes.
Until now.
And until now?
Until now. There
okay.
is no divorce
That's
in the
right.
Philippines,
okay.
right?
I thought until now there's a now a solution, but no, there's
no,
none.
No, there is none, no. except for, I believe,
Separation. Annulment.
And annulment, which is basically, when a person gets annulled, it says that there was never a relationship
a marriage
to begin with. So I want to talk to you about your sensibilities about this, like you being divorced, how have you sort of been able to manage and cope through that? Because I know it's not easy, and I know when that when you were going through that transition, you were also very isolated and you lost a lot of weight at the same time. Right? Didn't you or no?
No, that wasn't the reason.
Oh, that wasn't the reason?
Well, yeah, it was. I did go through a bit of depression through that 1 year before the divorce. And
how did you bounce back?
I kept myself busy with work. I was working back to back on TV shows and a movie.
Mm-hmm.
And I really didn't have time to grieve the loss of, you know, a loss of a relationship like that had lasted for 13 years. But slowly I even went through therapy, because I was so depressed, and the talk therapy helped me.
And this is in the Philippines?
This is in the Philippines.
This is amazing, because I know a lot of people in the Philippines, there's still sort of this stigma with, you know, I'm seeing a therapist.
Oh, no.
Right?
None
Good for
me.
You.
None
Good
for me.
You.
If you need help, go get it.
Yeah.
That's what you need.
Okay, so you've bounced back, and sort of now you're looking the best you've looked.
Thank you.
I have to say, mm-hmm. this girl works out, and you're also detoxing.
Yes,
you're
yes.
eating the right foods. So this change in lifestyle, how did you get towards that path?
Well, my cousin, who's here today, she's mm-hmm. going to share with you a little bit about how we detoxed and how she taught me to take care of my body. Really, what it all boils down to, what you put in your mouth, what emotions you have, they all play a role in your health. What you think about, the music you listen to, the people that you hang out with.
Mm-hmm.
I had been on a roller coaster in the Philippines with drinking.
Mm-hmm.
Because I got invited to so many events.
Of course, sa Pilipinas, mabarkada
and,
tayo.
Yeah. And
right? Like you and I.
Wine is overflowing. And,
right.
And so I just went to all these events. And then on top of that, I wasn't sleeping right, because my work schedule was so towards the morning.
Right. Erratic, yeah.
And so I was taking sleeping pills, and it was just a mess. And so my cousin comes in the right time, and she goes, "You got to do this detox." And I'm like, "I got to do this detox," because I knew what my body needed, really. Mm. I needed to stop, get all the junk out,
or toxins, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And just clean up. And once I quickly decided that I wanted to get in. It was hard in the beginning. No, actually, it was hard in the middle of the detox, because I wanted to give up. And we'll talk about that a little later.
Yeah.
But I did it, and I was so happy that I took those 14 days. 2 weeks. It just takes 2 weeks out of your life.
So it's basically a way to reset yourself, right? To put your mental frame in this sort of, I'm going to feed my body right.
I'm going to clean my liver.
I'm going to clean my liver, mm-hmm. because we only have one life, mga kababayan.
Yes.
So, you know, and as we know, Filipino food isn't the healthiest, right? How are you able to do this still living in the Philippines?
Well, my cousin, I was very lucky that it all happened for a reason, that she was with me in Manila, and she guided me through the steps. And they're very simple. Anybody can do it. It's just a matter of preparing what you're going to take for the day, and you have to have a mindset. You have to have a goal.
What was your goal?
Mine was to get off the pills and stop drinking so damn much. Mm-hmm. And I just kept that. When it got really hard, I said, well, I want to get healthy. Mm-hmm. I want to get healthy. So this is my path to get back to health. I mean, I have been healthy. I've been living a healthy lifestyle. But the toxins that you put in, no matter what exercise you do, if you're still putting crap inside your body, not going to work, right? Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. It's the dedication. It's the dedication to do this detox. Okay, when we return on Kababayan Today, pag uusapan natin tong detox na to. Ano ba yung detox na yan? You know, is that when you starve yourself and you don't eat? There are lots of misconceptions about detoxing. And also, I know that you work out regularly. I've worked out with Alice. She's doing all the stuff. I'm lying down.
No, not true. It's hard
to
get you into the gym.
Yes.
But once I got you into the gym, it was flowing from
there.
Yes,
that's right. Okay, when we return on the show, let's talk about how to kickstart your health here on Kababayan Today.